In this lecture, we are going to discuss about distortions from octahedral geometry. We know that in octahedral complex, there are six ligands are bonded to the metal. The coordination number of the metal is six. Now let us see how the distortion takes place. In octahedral geometry. In octahedral complexes, all the six bond lengths are not same. All the six bond lengths are not same between the metal and the ligand. As their shapes get changed or distorted, as the geometry of the complex becomes distorted, some of the metal ligand bonds becomes shorter and some of the metal ligand bonds becomes longer. Such octahedral complexes are called distorted octahedral complex. So why this distortion will be takes place? Why the distortion in that octahedral complex is takes place? So we have to take the example of an octahedral complex copper 2 plus with D9 configuration. Copper 2 plus, let us see, copper 2 plus with D9 configuration. So copper is having the atomic number. Copper is having the atomic number 29. And it has the electronic configuration argon 3d10 4s1. Now for copper 2 plus ion, the electronic configuration becomes equal to argon. This electronic configuration is 4s1, not 4s2. So it is 3d9 4s0. So there are 9 electrons in the d orbital. So when the splitting will be takes place, we can represent these electrons in this way. The arrangement of the electrons for d9 configuration, it is t2g6. It is t2g6. In T2g orbital, there are 6 electrons and Eg 3. T2g 6, Eg 3 orbital. So T2g, it is completely filled. T2g, it is completely filled. But now in Eg orbital, Eg 3, there are 3 electrons. Now there are 2 Eg orbitals, that is dz square and dx square minus y square. So as in copper 2 plus ion, there are 3 electrons in the Eg orbital. So how we can distribute these 3 electrons? So let us assume that the 2 electron in dz square orbital, let us assume this, imagine, and 1 electron in the dx square minus y square orbital. And other possibility is that 1 electron in dz square orbital and 2 electron in dx square minus y square orbital. Let us show this splitting of the orbitals in the copper 2 plus ion in presence of the surrounding ligand field. So lower T2g orbital, now there are 3 T2g orbitals and 2 Eg orbitals. Eg orbitals are dz square and dx square minus y square. And T2g orbitals are dxy divided and dxz. So in case of copper 2 plus ion, there are 9 electrons. So let us distribute the 9 electrons now. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So out of these 9, first the electron will be goes into the T2g orbital. Next 2 electron will be goes into the Eg orbital. Then next 3 electrons, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9 here. Okay, so 2 electrons in the dz square orbital suppose, and 1 electron will be into the dx square minus y square orbital. So distribution of electron, it is unequal and unsymmetrical. There are 2 electrons in dz square orbital and 1 electron in dx square minus y square orbital. So let us see how the distortion is takes place. In the first arrangement, there are 2 electrons in the dz square orbital and 1 electron in the dx square minus y square orbital. So as the 2 electrons are there in the dz square orbital, the d electron density will be greater in the z direction, because dz square orbitals are along the z axis. So let us show this by drawing the diagram here. Okay. So for this complex CuL6 oxidation state, it is copper 2+ having 3d9 4H0. In terms of T2G and Eg, it is having T2G6 and Eg2, Eg3. So in the first case, we know that dz square orbital should have 2 electrons and dx square minus y square orbital should have 1 electron. Dz square orbital should have 2 electron and dx square minus y square orbital should have 1 electron. So let us draw here the structure of the complex. Cu2+. These 2 ligands are at the trans position, that is along the z axis. And 4 ligands are the corner of the square. So this is the octahedral complex. This is the octahedral complex, CuL6. Now let us see here. We assume that first arrangement is that there are 2 electrons in the dz square orbital. So let us show the dz square orbital here. Dz square orbital. The lobes of the orbitals are lies along the z axis. So the electron density, 2 electrons are here. And remaining orbitals such as dx square minus y square orbital, as the orbitals are lies along the axis and ligands are approaches toward the central metal ion through the axis. So here is only 1 electron. So it means electron density will be less here. So this is dx square minus y square orbital having only 1 electron. And dz square orbital having 2 electrons. So thus there is unsymmetrical distribution of the electrons. Unsymmetrical distribution of the electrons in the this dz square orbital and dx square minus y square orbital. Now as the electron density along the z axis is greater, so there should be more repulsion between the electrons of the ligand with these d electrons. So the distance between the metal, that is copper 2+, because electron density is higher here, two electrons are here, so repulsion will be greater because ligands also carry the negative charge or electrons. So due to this, the d orbital are elongated along the z axis. That means on the z axis, the bond length will be increases, bond between the copper and the ligand. While as in the dx square minus y square orbital, only one electron is there. So electron density will be less. So the distance between the metal and the ligand will be shorter here. The distance between the metal and the ligand will be shorter here because less number of the electrons are here. So it means that two bonds get elongated along the z axis. This is z axis and this is x and y axis. As the electron density will be greater here in the dz square orbital, repulsion will be more. So bond length will be increases here due to the repulsion between the metal electrons and with ligand. So two bond becomes elongated. That is, bond length will be increases. And four bonds become shorter because less number of the electrons are here. So repulsion between this will be less. So more attraction between the ligand and the metal ion will be here. Here less attraction because electron density will be more here. So size of the d orbital will be increases here. So two bonds are shorter and four bonds are longer here. Two bonds are shorter and four bonds are longer here. Okay. It means that this complex, octahedral complex, get distorted because it is expected that the bond between the metal and the ligand should be, a bond length between the metal and the ligand should be same. But that is not here in the case of the copper complex. So two bonds get elongated along the z axis and four bonds becomes shorter. Bond length will be less here. So this type of the distortion in the geometry, it is called as distorted octahedral complex, or it is also called as tetragonally, this 1, 2, 3, 4 tetragonally distorted octahedral complex. When there is a unsymmetrical distribution of the electrons in the EG orbital. So this is tetragonally distorted octahedral complex. Tetragonally distorted octahedral complex. So in this way, distortion is takes place. So you can see here, we have been discussed the first arrangement. As there are two electrons in the dz square orbital, hence the d electron density will be greater in the z direction. So the ligands along z directions are more effectively screened from the nuclear charge of the copper 2 plus ion. And there is more repulsion and are repelled to a greater extent. Are repelled to a greater extent because there are two electrons in the dz square orbital, so repulsion will be expressed more. So this repulsion will be greater along the z axis as compared to the x and y axis. Because along the x and y axis, the dx square minus y square orbital is there. Therefore, the negative ligand field along z direction is less attracted toward the nuclear charge of the copper 2 plus ion. Because now the ligands are at the longer distance. Ligands are at the longer distance from the metal ion. So ligand field along the z direction is less attracted toward the nuclear charge of the copper 2 plus ion than the ligand field along the x and y axis. As we have shown in the diagram, as the two bonds are elongated and four bonds are longer, the two bonds are elongated and four bonds are shorter. This is because the ligand field along X and Y direction. It means that copper ligand attraction along Z direction becomes weaker because bond length is higher. So of course attraction will be weaker as compared to the copper ligand attraction along the X and Y direction. Let us show this once again. How the distortion will be expressed here, I would like to show this once again using the diagram. So let us show here the complex, copper complex. So along the Z axis, this distance between the metal ion and ligand will be larger. Because in the dz square orbital, we assume that two electrons are there. So electron density will be greater here. So due to the greater electron density along the Z axis, repulsion between the ligand and these electrons will be greater. So ligands are moving away from the central metal ion. Therefore, the attraction between the metal ion and the ligand, this copper 2 plus ligand attraction, the copper 2 plus ion ligand attraction will be less here. Along the Z axis, this, while along the X and Y axis, which orbital is there? Dx square minus y square orbital. And we assume that there is only one electron. So the ligands are here. Only one electron density, so repulsion will be less here. So the ligands become closer to the copper 2 plus ion. So therefore, the attraction between the copper 2 plus ion and ligand will be greater here. So as the attraction will be greater here, so four bonds become shorter and the attraction will be less here, the two bonds becomes longer. So we can represent this in this way. The two bonds are longer here. This bond distance will be longer and remaining bonds are shorter. Remaining bonds are shorter here. Okay. So try to understand about this. It means that the octahedral complex becomes distorted now. All the six bonds are not equal. Two bonds are longer and four bonds are shorter. And this is only takes place when there is an asymmetrical distribution of the electrons. It means dz square orbital is having the two electrons and dx square minus y square orbital is having only one electron. So along the z axis, the two bonds are longer and along the x and y axis, the four bonds are shorter. So due to this now, let us see what happens. Okay. So let us see the diagram this. So two bonds are longer, four bonds are shorter here. This diagram shows. This situation is called as Z out situation of CuL6 complex. We have taken the example of this complex. The four bonds are shorter and two bonds are longer. Z out situation means along the Z axis, the bond gets elongated. So due to this, what happens? As the four bonds are shorter, attraction is more there. Attraction will be more here. Hence, the crystal field splitting of EG orbital will be takes place. Because now the EG orbital cannot remain degenerate. In the octahedral complex, we know that the EG orbitals are degenerate there. Let us see the original splitting diagram.
let us see the
splitting diagram here. We know that the splitting of the 5d orbitals in presence of the surrounding ligand field. So 5d orbitals are splitted into the two groups, T2g orbital and Eg orbital. Now there are two Eg orbitals, dx square minus y square and dz square orbital. Dz square and dx square minus y square orbital. Now we assume that in case of the copper complex, there are two electrons will be here in the dz square orbital and only one is here. Now this unsymmetrical distribution of the electron density gives rise to the elongation along the z axis, that is two bonds are longer and four bonds are shorter. This is z out situation. Now these ligands are very close to the copper 2 plus ion, so attraction is greater here. So as there is a greater attraction and as here less attraction along the z axis, attraction will be less here and attraction will be greater here, attraction between the metal and the ligand. So as the force of attraction will be greater, crystal field splitting will be greater. That is, Eg orbitals are splitted now. So there is a decrease in the energy level of, now repulsion will be less here along the z axis. So there is a decrease in the energy of the dz square orbital and an increase in the energy of the dx square minus y square orbital. Thus, the degeneracy of the Eg orbital is removed over here. Degeneracy. What is the meaning of the degeneracy? In this case, the orbitals are degenerate. They are having the identical energy because there is an unsymmetrical distribution of the electron density. But if we see the approach of the ligands toward the central metal ion, then the ligands along the x and y axis are very close to the central metal ion. And the ligands along the z axis are away from the central metal ion. So the Eg orbitals not remain degenerate. Their degeneracy will be removed. So energy of dx square minus y square orbital will be increases because attraction is greater here between the metal ion and the ligand. So the energy of dx square minus y square orbital will be increases and energy of dz square orbital will be decreases to some extent. So this situation is called as z out situation. Okay, degeneracy of Eg orbitals. And this effect is called as John Taylor effect. There should be, if there is an unsymmetrical distribution of the electron, then the degeneracy of that orbital, it is removed and it is splitted here now into two orbitals, dz square orbital and dx square minus y square orbital. Thus, in the tetragonally distorted octahedral complex, such type of the splitting is takes place. So this is the first arrangement. This is the first arrangement. In the second arrangement, as there are two electrons in the dx square minus y square orbital and only one electron in the dz square orbital. So let us see what happens. See here, two electrons in the dx square minus y square orbital. So four bonds are elongated and two bonds get shorter. Now there is only one electron here. There are two electrons here along the z axis will be here. So therefore, you can see here two bonds are shorter and four bonds are longer. So this complex, it is a distorted octahedral complex. So in this case also, the degeneracy of this orbital, it is removed. So as the two bonds are shorter, their energy will be increases. And as the four bonds are longer, their energy will be decreases here. So this situation, it is called as Z in situation. Z in means at the Z orbital, the bond length becomes shorter. Okay. So this is called as Z in situation. and this effect was explained by the John and Taylor. So the effect, it is called as John Taylor effect. So in this way, in this video, in this lecture, I have been discussed about distortions from octahedral geometry, how the octahedral complex becomes case distorted. So we have explained in this video when there is unsymmetrical distribution of the electron density, then this type of the splitting takes place.